Channel. Today I am back with another review video, and it is super exciting because in my whole YouTube journey, I think I have done only 2 or 3 review videos. This one is going to be an eyeshadow palette review, and can you guess which eyeshadow I'm talking about? Yes, this one right here. I'm talking about the Morphe and James Charles palette. I mean, if you don't know what I'm talking about, then probably you are living under the rock, sorry to say. But the whole internet is like going gaga over this palette, and I am actually pretty late. I think I'm the last person in this world who is going to review this palette right now, because obviously this palette is not at all available in India. I got this from US directly, but from where I got it and how much I paid for it, all this info I am going to talk about in a bit. And I know my hair is looking mess because right now I am going through my transition period. I'm just growing out my hair, so please don't judge me. Also, I'm not naked, so without further ado, let's get started.
This is how the palette looks. It has like a matte black finish, and the Morphe X James Charles is written in a shiny background so that you can see it properly. It's a very minimalistic packaging, and it's very sturdy as well, but it's huge, like it's bigger than my head. And it is a like magnetic palette, which is great build quality. And once you open it, you can see all the colors, and the names are like written like this, which is pretty useless for me. But there are all the colors here, and he has this 39 colors in this single palette, and you can literally create anything possible with these many shades. I mean, visually, I am right now like literally shocked. The colors are really beautiful, and I can actually say that you can literally create anything, like any concept art or any eyeshadow. If you want like colorful looks, then opt for these two rows. If you are in a neutral kind of person, then you opt for these shades and these shades, which is like amazing. So that is that. And in US dollars, it retails for $39. In India, actually, I paid almost 3,700 rupees for this palette, because first of all, it is not at all available in India. You cannot directly buy from any store, because Morphe is not available in India. You can purchase it directly from their website, which is Morphe website. But if you are going for the shipping process, then you have to pay extra for your custom. But in India, if you are like putting your Indian address to as their shipping address, you have to pay some extra bucks for your customs. I'm not really sure, but the customs can charge you like some 800 rupees to 1000 rupees, but I'm not at all sure. I'm just guessing. And and apart from that, also I would like to say that there are few Instagram profiles who actually sell these palettes, and those palettes are 100% authentic. There are few profiles called International Makeup Brand or like Beauty Lounge India. I will link some of the profiles in my description box. If you want to check out, you can go and check it out there. Now, my problem was, to be very honest, 3,700 rupees I am spending for an eyeshadow palette, that is expensive. I mean, 3,700 rupees is quite expensive for an eyeshadow palette. But I wanted to get it because, first of all, I really love doing colorful looks. So, and all these colors are really tempting to get my hands on. I was like, you know what, I have to get it, because whenever I am creating a very creative look or a colorful look, I always struggle, and I always like reach out to at least 5 to 6 palettes just to get one eye look like full color coordinated and everything. And that is not possible for so many reasons, like that is not at all practical. But in India, when you are like looking for really colorful palettes, we are seriously lacking on those, because most of the Indian brands are till now in 2019, I would call it 2019 because it's almost like end of the year, they are still sticking to basic neutral colors, like all the browns, all the pinks, and all the, like, not even blues. Even if the most colorful palette, you can expect at least like 10 nude shades, 10 pink shades, and one or two blue shades. That's it. When I saw this palette, I knew that I have to get it. So I started like doing my research that from where I can get it. And actually, I came across these Instagram profile. Now all these Instagram profiles are selling authentic palette, but they are almost charging 4,500 to 4,700. Like, I am going to pay extra. That was not at all like not valid for me. So what I did was that I purchased directly from Morphe website, and I paid from my PayPal. Now that's why I also like ended up paying almost like 900 rupees extra, because I paid from HDFC Bank, and HDFC Bank has their own currency exchange rate. So I paid almost 3700 bucks. But how I get it, actually my cousin was coming to India, so I put his address as my shipping address. So basically Morphe shipped it in US only, and then he brought it into India. That's how I got my palette. Now let's just jump right in and let's just see how these colors are playing on Indian skin tone, because to be very honest, we all are like very much aware of all the controversies that this palette is like filled with press pigments, and people are getting kind of eye hives and everything. People are getting stained, but we are going to see if that is the case or not.
The look I'm planning to do today is like a very dramatic and kind of rainbow color with a little bit of body paint element. So I'm not going to do the entire talk through video while I'm applying the shadows, but definitely there is going to be a voiceover, and that is going to be 100% honest, so don't worry about that. Plus, you will be able to see if I'm like getting crazy fallouts or if these shadows are like blending properly or not. So don't worry about that.
First, I'm going to prime my eyes, of course, with an eyeshadow primer. This is from the NYX Professional Makeup Eyeshadow Primer, and this one is in the shade called Skin Tone. And I'm just applying it with my fingers and just blending it with my fingers too. Then I'm taking this very first shade in the palette called Canvas and just setting my eyeshadow primer. This eyeshadow primer is a bit tacky, so I needed to set that, and this shade is pretty pigmented as you can see, but the color actually is very light. I mean, it might work with like matte eyeshadows as a highlighter tone, or if you want to set your concealer or you want to just set your eyeshadow primer, then you should use this shade. Then I'm taking the shade called 10% off and just patting the shade with a small fluffy brush on my crease. You can see how slow and how precise I'm going here, because this is a technique that you need to work on with these shadows as per James Charles and as per every single influencer's video who has already used this palette. You do not want to just swipe it and just blend it in one stroke. First, you just lay down the colors and then you go and blend it just to get that maximum color pigment. And you can see there is like, till now there is zero fall off. I am like really liking the way it is working. It's not too soft, it's not too chalky, it's just perfect to work with. Then I'm taking this shade called Rusted, which is a bright orange shade, and just again patting over that 10% off shadow just to create a nice transition. Right now I haven't blend anything. I'm just laying down the colors, and once I'm done with that, then I'll just go in and blend. I thought the shadows are working really, really nice. I'm not really facing any kind of issues. They are really pigmented. I mean, you can see the color payoff in one stamp or in one stroke. Now it's time to blend those shades, and for that what I'm doing is I'm taking 518, the bright kind of yellowish tone kind of orange, and I am applying it to blend the shadows. Also guys, I have noticed one thing, that these shades are so pigmented that you might need to clean your brush
in between your usage, because it actually stains your brushes heavily, so you might not be able to create a nice smooth blended shade with just one eye brush. Just to blend it furthermore, I'm taking this bright yellow shade B. This is one of my favorite shade from this palette because I know how yellows can be hard to work with, especially on Indian skin tone. I mean, I have used yellows and it's really, really hard to make them pop, but this one is like bang on. Again, I'm not getting any fall off till now. I am really impressed with that. Once I'm done with my crease, I am going to lay on the colors, and for that I am taking this purple shade right here called Escape. I am going to create a halo eye. So what I'm doing is applying the Escape shade on the inner corner and the outer corner of my eye, and you can see the intensity of this color, guys. I mean, those warm tones are lying underneath this shadow, but still it is applying so beautifully, and so color payoff is like amazing here. To create a nice diffusing effect, I am taking this shade called Single and applying this right beside this dark purple shade. I'm taking this shade called Brother, which is a bright blue shade, and I am patting that with a flat brush just to create a smooth transition and make everything pop. I am using the shade called Playground in right middle of the eyelid, but now you can see that these shades are kind of creating like patchiness. I'm not really sure why this is happening. So I'm just moving forward and I am just going to deepen that crease out, and for that I'm taking this beautiful shade called No Beans. It's a very warm tone chocolate kind of shade, and I'm just applying it in the crease of my eyes. Moving on to the second eye, I'm taking this shade called Cola, and I am going to create a green halo look, and for that again I'm just applying that Cola shade in the inner corner and the outer corner of my eyelid. Again, zero fallout, which I am really shocked about. There is like literally zero fallout, and the kickback is also decent. I mean, I forgot to show you the kickback in the palette, but trust me, like, it's not nothing crazy out here. Just to create a smooth transition, I'm taking this shade called Daddy, which is a dark green shade, and I am applying right beside that blue. The shades are so vibrant and so opaque, I will say. Then, just to make it more smooth, I'm taking this bright green shade called Social Blade, and I am applying right beside the dark green shade. Then, just to make everything pop, I am going to apply this bright yellow shade right in the middle of my lid, and the yellow shade is called B. This yellow is just my favorite. Again, I'm just going in and just darkening the crease with the same shadows. Those are No Beans and Rusted.
Okay, so you saw what happened, what not happened. I definitely struggled to work with these colorful shadows, and I was most excited about only these colorful shadows, like the bottom two row, which is this two rows right here, because these colors are like screaming to me to use them and all. But definitely the technique you need to use with this kind of shadows is completely different. I will explain everything once I'm like completely done with the whole look. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply some foundation, concealer, and do my eyebrows off camera, and I'll be right back.
As I promised, I'm back with the eyebrows and my foundation, and now we are going to do our lower lash line, and for that I am going to first apply the shade called Skip, and I am using the shade on the very outer corner of my lower lash line, and I'm going to apply those same shadows for both of the eyes. Then I'm taking the shade called You Are Kidding, which is a red, and I am going to apply that right beside that shade called Skip. When I am doing the lower lash line, I notice that there is like a little bit of fallout, but that's fine because anyways I am going working with like my lower lash line, and I am packing my shadows heavily because My lower lash line is tend to be a bit darker from my lid. So I really want my colors to shone through. So that's why I am applying heavy handedly. But nothing crazy fallout is here. If there is like crazy fallout, you might have seen, but there is nothing crazy. So I am really satisfied by far. Now for the highlighter, I am going to take the shade called Ring Light. And I'm using it with a fluffy brush, but I just noticed that this is not very pigmented. I mean, I was expecting a little bit more pigmentation from this shade. I mean, you can definitely build it up and you can see like how pretty this color is. But I personally was expecting that it would be a bit more smooth and bit more pigmented. I'm going to make a inner corner highlighter brush wet with some makeup setting spray, and I'm going to dip that brush in the shade called Halo and apply it in my inner corner. The reason I am actually going directly with the setting spray because I have seen pretty much all the review videos, and in his own video also James has said that this particular shade is going to work great with some setting spray, so don't skip that. Generally shimmer shadows are tend to work great with setting sprays, so I'm fine with that. And I really like how pretty this color is looking. Now just to finish everything off, I am going to run a silver eye pencil in my lower lash line, and I'm going to coat my lashes with some mascara. This one is the Wet n Wild mascara, which is my current favorite, and I am going to apply some lashes and I'll be right back.
Okay guys, so finally I have finished my eyes, my lashes and everything is up, and I skipped in liner because this look doesn't really need one. And do I like it? Yeah, I love the way it turned out. But now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put all the shadows to contour my face, like upper part of my face, because this is the main reason actually that I opted for this palette, that I needed some really vibrant and pretty colors which I can use on my eyes and as well as on my skin, like a body painting type. So I'm gonna do that, and after I'm done with every single thing, then only I'm going to say my verdict. Wow, verdict. That sounds so heavy. But anyway, so let's just jump right in.
So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take Social Blade Daddy and B for the right side of my face, and I'm just going to blend it together to create that nice transition and that kind of highlight and contouring effect. Now while I was applying this shade on my face, you can see that it is creating some kind of patchiness. I'm not sure why it is like happening like that, but I tried to go back and kind of create this smooth effect, but I couldn't really. I'm not sure what I have done wrong. Now for the left corner of my face, I am going to take the shades called Single, Escape and Skip, and just going to create that contouring and highlighting effect. But here you can see actually the purple and the pinks are going to work like very nicely. I don't know what's wrong with the greens and yellow, but the purples are working actually better than the greens. And to highlight my face, I'm going to reach out to that same palette and I'm going to use the shade called Face, because from the name literally it indicates that you can use this as highlighter. But again, what I have noticed that the color payoff is a bit muted and I wanted a kind of blinging highlighter. So what I did was like I opted with the finger, and you can see the effect. It instantly gives the desired effect, which is good because you that way you can control your highlighting effect. If it is really pigmented in one stroke, there is a chance that you overdo it. Now I'm just going to finish the look very quickly, and for that what I'm doing is I'm just applying some dots actually from the white body paint, and I'm applying them with an eyeliner brush, and once I'm done with that I'm just quickly paint the face and the rest of my body with some water activated white body paint. And this look is actually inspired by the theme of this palette, that is Unleash Your Inner Artist.
Hey guys, so finally I'm done with everything. unleash your inner artist theme look. I wanted to create that, so everything is done. So now it's time for my final verdict. What do I think? How do I feel about this palette? I think this palette is really great. The pigmentation of this, all the shadows are really great. The collection of the shades are really amazing, but I really struggled a lot to work with them because the whole shadow palette, like majority of the shadows are pressed pigments, and James has clearly said in his video that you need to work with a different technique when you are working with these pressed pigments. Like you have to go in patting motion, and so that you get the maximum color deposit. So you just have to like deposit and then blend, deposit and then blend. So I really struggled with that, especially with the purple shade and the yellow shade. I mean, the yellow shade was like bang on. I have never seen any yellow shade work so nicely on Indian skin, because to be very honest, Indian skin tone does have yellow tone, but this one is really pigmented. But whenever I was trying to blend it with a fluffy brush, it was kind of creating patches, and like it gave me like really hard time. But I think I have already found my favorites, that is these row and these four shades. Actually, they are amazing to create any kind of warm smoky eye look or any kind of warm tone eye look. And those kind of warm tone eye looks are really going to look great on Indian skin tone. So now the second question is, do you really need this palette? Like, is this a must have in your collection? So if you're someone who really like nude colors, like nude is your bae, then I don't really think that you need this palette. Because if you like, to be very honest guys, if you have this palette and you are not even using these shades and you are just stuck to these mid-row, you are not going to do justice to this palette. Apart from that, what I would like to say that if you're a beginner, I would say that you need to stay away from this palette, because I struggle a lot with the blending technique. And if you're new to makeup and you are learning how to blend an eyeshadow, then definitely this palette is going to be very intimidating for you. If you want to buy it, then buy it. But I just wanted to put it out there.
Also, I would like to mention one very important thing that James has specifically told, that these shadows are not going to work with concealer. I mean, like majority of beauty community puts concealer as their eyelid primer, but James has specifically said, and I have seen like pretty much all the review videos, and whoever has used concealer as primer, they have struggled with the blending a lot. And also James has specifically said that these shadows are tend to work best with MAC Paint Pot, which I think is kind of bit too much, because I have already spent $3,700 for this palette. Now I have to go and purchase MAC Paint Pot worth ₹2,500. I'm not going to do that. That was actually a little bit of disappointment for me, because pretty much every eyeshadow should work with, and actually pretty much every eyeshadow works with concealer, but for this particular palette I had to opt for eyeshadow primer specifically. Now I have used a NYX one, and that actually worked really nicely. Now if you're someone who doesn't have an eyeshadow primer, so you have to buy an eyeshadow primer specifically just to work with this eyeshadow palette. One more thing I have noticed, all the highlighting shades kind of bit chalky. I mean, those are pigmented but not really buttery smooth. You have to like go in and build it up.
This palette is like not travel friendly, because like look at the size, I mean come on. But if you want to travel with it, then I would say that you can create every possible look in this entire freaking earth with these shades. And what I really like about this palette is like the most shadows which you are tend to use in every single look has this like bigger sizes. And even if you like look, break this palette down into 4-4-4 ways, so like you can create a look with this, you can create a look with this, you can create a look with this. The color selection and the way they have presented is amazing. So do I really recommend it? Yes, I recommend it, totally I recommend it. If you are someone like me who love 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 colorful looks, then this palette is everything guys. And this is like my first Morphe palette. I'm really excited about that. But I just want to say that I'm not someone who like
go crazy about international brands and everything. But this palette, I wanted to have this because of the colors, and I'm really satisfied with that. So yeah, that was my review for James Charles palette. If you like this video, then don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to my channel. I really worked hard for this video, so please subscribe. That will mean the world to me.